In this video, we'll address the deployment of our three sensors capture and processing application onto an embedded computing device, in this case an NVIDIA Jetson AGX Orin board. First of all, connect the SBG IMU to the NVIDIA Jetson board over USB. Same with the camera. The Lidar is connected with an Ethernet interface via switch in our case due to the presence of a laptop we'll use in the development phase as well. On the board, start the RTMaps Daemon service. On the laptop, start the RTMaps Studio. Connect the Studio to the board's RTMaps Daemon service. Two diagrams are already registered on the board. Request the daemon to spawn an RTMaps runtime process on the board with the diagram called test. Then connect the studio to the newly created runtime process. The diagram is empty at this point. Let's start with the Lidar data capture. Create a UDP socket component, register the Velodyne package and create the Lidar stream decoding components. A 3D viewer is created as well for display purposes on the board display if present. Connect the components. Provide a Velodyne calibration file, already on the board, thanks to the remote file browser in the RTMaps Studio. Configure the UDP socket to receive packets arriving on port 2368, and run. The RTMaps diagram starts running on the board. You can see the captured point cloud shown on the board's display. Back to the laptop, let's integrate the SBG IMU sensor. Register the appropriate package. Add an SBG device component and a corresponding decoder. A devectorizer component with three outputs and a scope component can be used to plot the measurements. We can also add a second 3D viewer to display the sensor attitude in a 3D environment. Transform Euler angles into a transformation matrix. Configure the 3D viewer also with point of view and lighting properties. Now, run the diagram again and check out the results on the embedded board display. Let's integrate our third sensor, the camera. register the RTMaps_video4Linux package. Add a capture component to our diagram. Here we configure the camera to provide a JPEG compressed video stream. We can then insert a JPEG decompress component to get RGB frames out of it. Add an image viewer. Run and check out the result on the board display. Note, it could have been possible as well to start with the diagram we made on the laptop in the previous video. Copy it to the board, and reuse it almost directly. Let's continue with the integration of an AI algorithm for processing the video stream. Take the algorithm component from another diagram available on the laptop. And copy-paste the corresponding components on the active diagram on the board. Feed it with video data, run, and check out the results on the board. Let's imagine we would like to stream data from our board to the laptop. We pick the processed video stream and compress it in JPEG here in order to reduce the required network bandwidth. Add a socket sender component and provide it with the laptop interface IP address. Note, with the DDS components now in RTMaps, this IP configuration wouldn't be required. Back to the laptop. Our active diagram on the laptop's RTMaps runtime engine is still empty at this point. Add a socket receiver in order to receive the JPEG video stream from the board. Decompress the JPEG frames and add an image viewer. Run both diagrams. We can now visualize on the laptop what is processed on the board. Last refinement, the video frame's timestamps transferred from the board to the laptop do not include the timestamping information. The RTMaps clocks are also not synchronized between the RTMaps runtime running on the board and the one running on the laptop. Let's configure the RTMaps master-slave distribution. Configure the RTMaps runtime engine on the board as slave. Request it to connect to our master diagram on the laptop. Now configure our laptop's RTMaps runtime as master. We can see the incoming connection from the slave. Running the laptop diagram will also control the execution start on the board's diagram. Both RTMaps processes clocks now remain in sync, exchanging synchronization frames. We can now send the timestamps along with the data samples between the two diagrams in order to preserve stream's latency information, measure the communication delays, etc. In a few minutes, we build a diagram from scratch capturing data from three different sensors on an embedded board, added some processing, and established synchronized data streaming with a remote computer. Thanks for watching.